What do you do when you lose on your homecoming in 1 week? Well, you try to ruin somebody else's homecoming the next week. That's exactly what Ohio football will try to do on homecoming at Bowling Green on Saturday. I'm Russ Eisenstein, the voice of the Ohio Bobcats. Welcome to our Week 7 game week preview. Can you believe it? We're on the backside of the regular season already. And as always, we're presented by the Athens County Convention and Visitors Bureau on the web at athensohio.com. It's the 4-2 and 1-1 Bobcats and the 1-5 and 1-1 Bowling Green State University Falcons on homecoming at Doyd Perry Stadium on Saturday. Yes, Ohio lost 26-23 to Central Michigan this past Saturday on homecoming in Athens. And it was tough to take because the Bobcats turned the ball over four times. But even with that, the four turnovers, Ohio was in the ballgame and lost only by three. You can't change the plays and you can't change the result, so you have to move on from that. Moving on from that series in which Ohio has won just five games against the Chippewas, they move to a series in which Bowling Green has the all-time edge, 40-26-2. Ohio has lost four of the last five in this series. They ended a four-game losing streak with a home win here in Athens last year. The Bobcats have taken just four of the last 10, and that's corresponded with BG being at or near the top of the MAC East, where Ohio has resided over the last decade. Last year, well, it was homecoming in Athens. It turned out to be tight in the scoreboard, but in the rest of the contest, it really didn't seem that way. Ohio was in control.
30-24 was the final, but it really didn't feel like just a six-point win. The second quarter was key. Up 3-0, the Bobcats outscored BG 20-7 in the second 15 minutes. Malik Irons bookended the period with two touchdown runs. In the middle, Greg Windham slung it to Sebastian Smith for a score, 23-7 Cats at the half. The QB was key in getting Ohio to 30. The Falcons scored the final 14 points, and the Cats were forced to field an onside kick to paint it green and white. The victory got the two teams' records to exactly what they are now, the Bobcats at 4-2 and the Falcons at 1-5. BGSU went 4-8 in Mike Jenks' first season, 2016. That was the Falcons' first losing campaign since going 5-7 in 2011 and was their third sub-500 season in 10 years. In that time, there was a bowl win, 33-28 over South Alabama in the Camellia Bowl, and two MAC titles in 2013 and 15, both over Northern Illinois. It's important to remember that from 1982 to 1992, BG brought home the league crown four times. When Ohio was enjoying the Bill Hess years of excellence, the Falcons were flying high with Doyd Perry, who their stadium is named after. From the mid-50s to mid-60s, they won six MAC titles. The start of this season was a nightmare. Two Big Ten losses, a home opening loss to the FCS, a tight loss in Tennessee, and a MAC opening setback. 35-10 was a final at Michigan State. South Dakota's 5-0 and ranked fourth in the FCS, and the Coyotes won at the Doit 35-27. Northwestern rolled in week three, 49-7 in Evanston. Middle Tennessee won 24-13 in week four. Akron won the MAC opener 34-23. And then finally last week, the Falcons flew away with a win, 37-29 at Miami. The key part of that game came when Miami was inside the 10 trying to take the lead. Well, they fumbled, and BG's Brandon Harris rambled 93 yards to put it away. 37-29, the final. James Morgan threw for two touchdowns and was picked three times last year against Ohio as a freshman. He's thrown for seven touchdowns and four picks this year as a sophomore. Tael Redding seems like he's been there forever. He's a senior now and has 416 receiving yards and three TDs. On the ground, Josh Cleveland has 406 yards and two touchdowns. Defensively, Harris has a team-high 46 tackles, three for loss, and three fumble recoveries from his linebacker spot. Cornerback Clint Stevens has two interceptions. All told, BG is at or near the bottom in the league in team offensive and defensive categories, but they do force turnovers. 14 of them, 11 have been fumble recoveries.
Turnovers will be important. We talked about that in the open in this segment, and we'll conclude with it as well. Talked with quarterback Nathan Rourke about those turns from last week. Felt bad about it, but the only way that he could look at it is it's a learning experience and he has to move forward. He says down the line he hopes to look back on that game against Central Michigan and say that was certainly something that solidified the premise of ball security. He also has 16 touchdowns this year, so he has certainly done great things for Ohio through the first 6 weeks, and hopefully he will again. Injuries are piling up, though. You'll have to tune into our pregame show on the radio network on Saturday to find out who's a go and who isn't. Also, this is a key portion of the schedule. This is the last road game before three in a row at home. Ohio will take on Kent State, Miami, and Toledo in back-to-back-to-back weeks at Peden Stadium. So if you could get one on the road, that's big going into this very important homestand. Ohio will conclude the regular season on the road this year at Akron and at Buffalo. The game's on ESPN3, and it also is going to be a beautiful day at Doyd Perry Stadium. It's raining as we tape this now, but very little chance of rain in the forecast on an 80-degree sunshine splash Saturday afternoon in Northwest Ohio. Our radio network pregame will begin at 2:30 with a kick at 3:30 as Rob Cornelius, Ryan Boyd, and I will have it for you. It's Ohio and Bowling Green on homecoming in Northwest Ohio. And that's our game week preview presented by the Athens County Convention and Visitors Bureau on the web at athensohio.com. For Jason Shapino, I'm Russ Eisenstein, and this is Bobcat TV.